Every year, thousands of youth graduate from various universities and tertiary institutions across the country. However, a big portion of them barely find employment in their fields of specialization, while others opt for self-employment to sustain themselves. This is attributed to a number of factors, among them lack of employable skills by the graduates. This prompted the Uganda Institution of Professional Engineers to come up with a program of training graduates so as to equip them with skills.
Now, the fresh graduates are normally very low on skills because the 4 years or 2 years spent in university or college respectively are not sufficient to provide skills equivalent to that of a practitioner who has been in the field with a lot of exposure. So it is a bridging program. And on this bridging program, of course, we have demand because we have fresh graduates.
The program saw over 200 graduate engineers get hands-on skills. Engineer Muhwezi further called upon the government to implement policies and laws for the introduction of graduate training programs in government institutions and private sector.
We have had a number of host organizations supporting us, some of them taking on 2, others 4, others even 10. But we have also had organizations which are not welcoming this program. And the fact that as a country, we are talking about strengthening local content in manufacturing, for industrialization, in big contract participation, we want to appeal to the employers, host organizations, that we have about 1,000 fresh graduates of engineering coming out of different universities and colleges.
One of the stakeholders for the graduate training program is the European Union, which cited that such programs are essential in the country since they play a crucial role in curbing unemployment among graduates, as Leonard Derrida explained.
Finally, obviously, as development partners, our goal is to accompany the people of Uganda in their in this growth and on this path to development. So for us, it is important to be there for the youth. We will continue to invest in technical and vocational training. We will have quite a substantial program that we're going to develop. For which obviously we are also looking into ways in promoting this future development for engineers.
Students who attended the training have lauded the Uganda Engineering Professional Body for equipping them with the necessary skills.